We have a 3D image of kyphosis. We've been using that word a lot, so I want to bring that up if possible. And Dr. Mena, it's in front of you. If you can show me what exactly we're looking at.
So the kyphosis will be the terminology that we say that the spine is a little more wedged towards the front. So normally the spine, we have three curvatures, three main curvatures. So we have the cervical spine or the neck. We have in this direction here, same as the lumbar spine, which we call lordosis. So we have a cervical lordosis and a lumbar lordosis. So the thoracic spine or the middle back, the curvature is opposite to the, or is in different direction than the neck and the back. So that's what we call a kyphosis. So in other words, kyphosis just stands for a different type of curvature. So if the curvature is more pronounced, then we say it's an exaggerated kyphosis or kyphosis.
Right. And just looking at that, doctor,
that's fairly normal.
Fairly normal,
yeah,
huh?
It looks
That's
normal.
Fairly normal.
Okay.
So in my practice, I do a lot of spinal deformity work. So kyphosis isn't necessarily a bad word. So it's something that everyone has kyphosis in their back. And
okay.
Actually, if you're lacking kyphosis and if you're holding yourself in a position that you're straighter than you should be, that can also be problematic. But what we see is if a patient reports a change from their baseline. So I had a gentleman come in last week who actually does have scoliosis. And he was mentioning that he was getting a worsening, sort of tilting over. He wasn't feeling that he was standing as straight as he used to and things like this. And actually did present with vertebral compression fractures. So what we also need to recognize is not everyone comes in with perfectly straight back. Some people do, some people don't, and it's more your change from baseline and your symptoms.